What's up, everybody? This is Alyssa Amoroso, aka Publyssity. Who is ready to spill some tea? Because this is Tea with Publyssity.
You could take your shopping to a whole new level by using the Macy's app. I actually, ironically, just downloaded it this week because I am furnishing my apartment and my podcast studio with items from Macy's. So I figured it was just an easy way to quickly access everything. The Macy's app helps you stay on top of online orders, returns, and you could take advantage of the price checking feature. Plus, you earn Star Rewards, and Star Rewards members get special features like Star Money updates and exclusive savings sent right to your phone. So you could download it today for iOS and Android. Let's get into today's episode.
What's up, D-Tribe? Welcome back to Tea with Publyssity 2023. It's also my birthday today, January 4th, so thanks for spending my birthday with me. I highly recommend you watch this episode on either Spotify or YouTube because I'm doing it vlog style. If you're listening on audio, that's completely fine. But if you hear me like clinking around, it's because I'm doing a little get ready with me style video today. I'm going to be doing my hair and my hair is done. I'm going to be doing my makeup and we're going to be talking about manifesting, setting goals for the new year, and vision boarding. I've talked about this in years past, but like having my birthday fall on the new year or like right after it, it's interesting because some years I feel a lot of pressure from it. Some years I'm like, oh my God, this is so much to take in because it just feels like such a fresh start in terms of, like I said, like a new year and a new age. But this year, I don't really feel that way. I feel like these last few months, especially since I moved, I've just been in this era of like, I've been in this era of just like not putting pressure on myself or not putting pressure on anything. I think I almost like kind of have to do that right now as like self-protection, given the fact that my life has had so much like change. I also think I'm doing that partially because I know it's like everything's going to work out the way it's supposed to. If you're watching this and you see the mess behind me, I have my last few days in this shitty little Airbnb. So I am excited to get out of here. Next week, I move into my permanent place. But yeah, let's talk about it. So let's talk about goals. Let's recap 2022. I did post on my Instagram a little 2022 recap of my favorite things from the year, including my favorite clothing brands, my favorite clothing items that I purchased, my favorite books that I read. If you want to check that out, it's on my Instagram. It's just a cute little list. But in terms of 2022, I was having this really weird, I do this really weird avoidant thing where sometimes if I don't want to deal with something that is like mentally challenging, I won't go there. So for example, like let's say I'm with a guy and he cheats on me, I just will never think of him again. Like maybe subconsciously I will. Maybe I'll have nightmares or anxiety, but like every time my brain thinks about it, I'm like, nope. And I feel like I kind of did that with 2022 a little bit. I was seeing everyone make these like end of year posts and I couldn't go there. I just felt so unprepared to go back and reflect because I was nervous that as I reflected, I would just see so many pictures and videos from my old job. And I guess I haven't healed that much. On the surface, I've healed. And like in my gut, I've healed. Like I know that everything happened for a reason and it happened in the right way. But I think like I hold a lot of resentment which is normal. Like, I'm one of those people who I hold resentment for a really long time. No, not a really long time at all. Like, a year or two when something major happens. And then it's, like, poof, out of my brain as if nothing ever happened. So I'm not at that point yet where nothing happened. I actually have something interesting to tell you guys about that topic, but we'll get into that in a little. I'm not there yet, and I feel like I didn't want anything to trigger me. So I was like, I'm not recapping my year. I'm not even thinking about it. And then I forced myself to think about it. And as I thought about it, I was like, wait, that's not so bad. Why are you avoiding this? Like, are you nuts? Like, you did so much, like, career aside in 2022 that you should be proud of. And I think I realized that as I did very briefly recap my year on my Instagram stories. I mean, I had my second sold out live show, which is, like, literally my favorite thing in the world. I love connecting with you guys. I have met the most incredible tea drivers doing my live shows. Like, it makes me feel so much closer to you guys and my podcast community. So I had that to be proud of. I got laid off, but I also literally got a manager the next day, got my biggest partnership ever. I mean, I hit the ground running. I moved to LA. I bought my first car. My nephew was born. I mean, so much happened. So when I reflected, I was like, oh, also, I went to Italy, my dream location. I went to Paris last year. I mean, everything. And so as I reflected, I was like, why are you running from this? Like, yes, there was hurt, but there was so much growth. And I'm happy that I decided to look back at it. And so if you're being avoidant of anything that happened last year to you, I challenge you to look at it, find the silver lining, and find the positives. Because it's probably not as bad as you thought. And if it is as bad as you thought, maybe things will be better this year. But you can't avoid it, because then those things just, like, eat you up inside. And speaking of, like, avoiding things and whatever, I had a falling out with a friend, like, maybe 2 years ago. Like, it's been a long time at this point. And it wasn't like anything really happened between us. We just kind of stopped hanging out and talking. So again, I carried resentment because I felt burned and I felt sad and, you know, I felt abandoned. And I was on the plane coming back to LA after Christmas, and I just had this, like, feeling that I wanted to reach out to her. And, like, I didn't do it for her per se. I did it for me. I think if I was doing it for her, then it wouldn't be, like, aligned in my integrity. But I did it for me. And I reached out and I was just like, hey, like, I don't really know where the breakdown in our communication was or why our friendship even ended. Like, I could hardly even remember. But I just want you to know, like, I no longer hold any ill will or any resentment. And I, excuse me, I still have a cough. I'm like, and I'm genuinely so happy to see that you're doing well. And, like, I wish you all the best. And I sent it, realizing, like, I might not get a response, or I might get a response of her being like, I fucking hate you, bitch. And it was better than I could have expected. She wrote back, clearly had grown in the time that we spent apart, and was like, I was in an unhappy place. Like, I've gone to therapy. I've learned so much about myself. And I, like, realized that I had a lot of, like, friendships fall apart. And, like, I hold absolutely no ill will towards you. And I'm coming to LA and I'd love to see you. So I'm seeing her next week. And, like, it felt so good to, like, set that free and be like, wow, like, there's no bad juju out there. And, like, I feel like a lot of what I carry around, this, like, shame and guilt that I carry around, is, like, thinking people don't like me, or, like, feeling self-conscious about things. And like, she wasn't mad at me. She's like, oh yeah, no, everything's fine. And I even felt that way today on my birthday because some people from my previous job who have said nothing to me in since I got laid off, like literally just cut communication with me. I have this narrative in my head like, oh my God, they hate me. Like they must hate me. People reached out to me for my birthday. And I'm like, wait, they don't hate me. We just don't talk. And that's okay. And like that was another reminder for me. So like, I don't know. I guess my point in telling you guys this is that like, if you feel like there's bad juju out there or energy or something that's weighing you down, like it's a new year. It's a clean slate. Reach out, make amends with people. Do it for yourself because it feels like a weight's been lifted when you do it. And don't be attached to the outcome because they might not be so nice back, but they might be. You never know. So yeah, I mean, at the start of this year, I spent Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, and New Year's completely alone. I flew home. I hosted a Macy's Live, which was literally incredible. I love doing live television. I worked. I went to Jill's. She had a Hanukkah party. And then I woke up so sick, like literally so sick. And I had a fever Christmas Eve and Christmas Day. And my family felt so bad. They didn't want me to spend it alone. But like, I didn't want to be around them because I didn't want to get them sick. So they went and celebrated. And I stayed home and I slept. And I missed both holidays after I flew across the country to be home for them. And then I came back to LA and I still felt sick on New Year's. So I made the grown-up decision to stay in and not push myself. And that's how I started the year. And you know what? I'm okay. Again, I had no expectations, genuinely. Then I woke up on New Year's Day and I drove my ass to Malibu and I went on a hike. And it was a good day, a good way to start the new year. And like, I just want to also say to you guys, you know, there was points in the hike, like it was, this hike was uphill, you know, it was not easy. There were points where I was out of breath and I was like, felt out of shape. And I was like, oh my God, I should turn and go down the other way. And then I just kept talking to myself and pushing myself and saying, it's okay. No one's here pushing you along. Go at your own pace. Like, this is how you get better at things. You keep doing them until you build a tolerance and you're able to do more. Like, you want to hike more this year, and this is what comes with the territory. So saddle up and do it. And I was patient with myself, and I took my time, and I went at my own pace, and I hiked that freaking mountain. So if you're doing anything this year, if you're pushing yourself, if you're setting goals as we now transition into talking about goals, just be patient with yourself and give yourself grace. I also started listening at night to affirmations. You go on Spotify and you put like affirmations playlist on, and I found just like a 5-minute thing of a guy, you know, saying nice things like you are worthy, you are loved, blah, 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 blah. I don't even know what it says because I fall asleep as he's talking to me, which is good. So like in your subconscious, you're hearing these positive things. So that's also something I've been doing that you guys could implement. I haven't done it every night, but the nights I remember, I do it. And it's been nice. I think I put too much blush on, but that's besides the point. Okay, let's talk about goal setting. So I started before the new year even making a digital vision board. I think I've done vision boards every year for maybe 4 or 5 years now. And not everything on your vision board always comes true in that calendar year, but I find it to be a really good way to organize your thoughts and put your ideas to paper. So what I recommend doing. I'm going to talk about digital vision boards, and then I want to talk about physical vision boards. So if you're doing a digital vision board, which this was my first year doing it, usually I do a physical one. I use the app Canva. I thought it was really helpful. They give you templates. I think I just even wrote in the search bar. I wrote like vision board template, and some things came up and I used one of them. And then I went to Pinterest and I found pictures. And what I liked about doing the digital one is that I was able to get really granular. So I really want to manifest love in this upcoming year. I want to meet a partner. And I did one page. I'll share this on Instagram with my subscribers just because it is pretty personal. So I'm just going to share it with my subscribers, not like every single person that follows me. So you guys could subscribe there and I'll post it. But I put like the kind of partner that I want, and I did one page of like what I want in a relationship. So it's like fire, passion, this, that. It's like more like physical. And then I did another page that is partner attributes. And then I did pictures that showed those attributes. So I did like a lock to show commitment. I did like a picture of a safe to show like feeling safe. I did a picture of like a man handing another man an umbrella to show someone that's selfless. And I made these visual representations. Then I did two career boards for work. And one of them was like brands that I want to work with. And then one of them was really granular. And it was like pictures of people that inspire me in the industry whose careers I'd like to mimic. Or, you know, things like finances. Then I did like a self one, like certain things that I'd like to put in my life this year is I'd like to go to acupuncture. It's been something I've been saying for a while. So I put a picture of someone getting acupuncture. I put a picture of someone meditating because I love to meditate and I want to implement it more. So you could just get really granular and find pictures and things that speak to you. In terms of making a physical vision board, I would recommend getting a like poster board and picking up magazines from different genres. So you want to go to like Shape magazine, fitness magazines. Then you want to do like Cosmopolitan if you're looking for stuff about sex and love. Then you want maybe a fashion magazine, maybe a Town and Country if you want something about decor, or a travel magazine. And you find different magazines in different categories. It could be kind of pricey, so maybe you want to check and see if there's any ones that are used. And then you just cut out things that speak to you, and you flip through them and be really careful about what you're looking through. So, for example, you know, the word content came to mind. I found a magazine and it said contents, like, you know, the contents in the magazine. So I cut off the S and used the word content. So you can get creative. You could cut out different letters and spell things out. When you're doing the physical one, it definitely takes more digging to find exactly what you want. But I did do both because I was used to doing physical ones in the past. As you guys know, I always do it with Jill. And this year we are apart, which sucks. But we both still upheld the tradition. She did it with her friends in Miami, and I did it with my new friend Alex here in LA. And Alex and I had signed up for a manifestation sound bath and meditation class here in LA, which was really cool. And we went, and they had all magazine cutouts, and I made one. And it's very like in line with my digital one. It has all the main overarching themes. The only difference is that my digital one is, like I said, more granular. So that's how you do it. I think, let me show you guys. I have it right here. It doesn't, you know, take rocket science. Okay. If you're listening on podcast, I will try to explain what I'm showing. But basically, it's my vision board, and just looking at it at first glance, I kind of have mine sectioned off. I kind of like to always do different things. So like in the top left corner is career focused stuff. The bottom left is more about like self-work. The middle is like fitness and wellness. Top right is about love. Bottom right is about traveling and nature. So again, you could do it however you really want. This is how I do it. This is how it works for me. And I've just always found this to be like such a great way to just organize your goals and your thoughts. And I don't know, I love it. So I hope that you guys do it. Please tag me if you do. I'm also sitting here doing my makeup literally in the dark. I have no idea what it looks like. Uh-oh. But yeah, I don't know. I hope that helps you guys. And I'm really excited for this year. I am, like I said, moving into my new apartment next week. But the catch is that since I'm moving cross-country and they're shipping my stuff, it takes 2 weeks for my stuff to get here. So my stuff literally may not be here for weeks. So I'll either be sleeping on an air mattress. I don't know what I'm going to be doing. Like, you can't make this shit up. It is not for the faint of heart moving cross country. But again, no expectations. If anything, I'm just really excited. I've been feeling really, really good since moving here, like mentally. I feel like this sounds like so sad, but I remember in New York, like when people would say like, oh my God, I just wake up so happy. In my head, I'm like, what's that like? Like, I haven't felt that way in so long. And the other night I was driving home from being at my friend's house, and I just had this thought, and I was like, I'm so happy. And I was like, oh my God, that's what it feels like. I'm happy. And I don't know if it's the weather. I don't know if it's the change of scenery. I think I just have a new energy here. Like, I don't feel as lazy or like I want to isolate. Like, I've been more social. I've been pushing myself out of my comfort zone. I've also been like wanting to explore a lot. I think because the state of California in general is so new to me. So it's like, I want to go do things. Like this weekend, I'm going to Big Bear for my birthday and I'm taking a ski lesson because I want to explore like the nature that California has. And oh, I wish that light would go on. But yeah, I don't know. I'm feeling really happy and good. And like, it's not like all my problems changed overnight, but I do feel a sense of like hope and excitement for this year ahead. I did turn 32 today, and like, I don't know, I'm just happy to be an even number. For some reason, like 32 feels so much better than 31 did, which is weird because I'm older, but like I'm happier about it. I feel like all these good things are going to come to me because I'm in the mindset of manifesting them and welcoming them. And it really doesn't even have to do with the new year as much as it has to do with this new change that I made. And then like, I think I'm just proud of myself for making a change like this and, you know, getting myself out of a situation that I wasn't happy in. So if you guys are feeling stuck, maybe it's redecorating your apartment. Maybe it's moving. Maybe it's just like working on some like feng shui. Like, I don't know. Things don't change unless you do. So that is what I will leave you guys with. Thank you so much for tuning in today. I will post my final makeup and birthday outfit look to TikTok. I'm sorry that the lighting is shitty. I don't have any like studio lighting in my Airbnb. I'm also recording this on my phone because I couldn't find the charger to my camera. Guys, it's a shit show. But again, we're rolling with the punches. I love you guys so much. Thank you for tuning in. And I'm really excited for this year of the podcast. I feel like it's going to be the best year of the podcast yet. So thank you guys. Love you.